We like to think scientists are the ultimate boffins, those who among us who know more than anyone else. But did you know there are some things scientists have found that even they don't understand? These are the creepiest discoveries that left scientists scratching their heads. Number 15. Screaming mummies. Mummies are a pretty standard inclusion in the world of creepy, scary things, along with vampires, witches, and werewolves. But if you want your nightmares to be a little more terrifying, then you need to take a look at these screaming mummies. As though dead people from thousands of years ago wrapped up in bandages weren't scary enough, these mummies have spent the last few millennia stuck in a permanent state of screaming, which made people think that they may have died a pretty awful death before being wrapped up and put in their sarcophagus. In truth, it's actually down to a little laziness on the part of the mummy wrapping dude, whatever you call that job. You see, sometimes mummies would not have a jaw wrap applied, and then over the years, decomposition would cause the jaw to hang loose, making it look like it was screaming. The first screaming mummy was discovered in 1881, and the sarcophagus was unmarked, which was a sign of disgrace and would stop him going to the afterlife, according to the Egyptian mythology. So maybe the jaw wrapping was left off intentionally in this case as a kind of warning or punishment. Like this video, smash the subscribe button, and click the notification bell right now, or this centipede will crawl on your face when you're sleeping. Now it's time for the juicy topic. Just what is this door? And what is it doing there? People just don't know. As you can see, the door is at the top of a hard-to-reach peak, at the top of a small, slender mountain-like structure. The obvious conclusion is that it was built and used by an ancient civilization. But how could humans reach that? And how could they fit in the tiny space behind the door? A common theory is that this might have been home to something more like goblins. Yeah, really. But that can't be the case, can it? What do you think? As always, comment down below with the hashtag #JuicyTopic and let us know your opinion in relation to what we just showed on screen. Let's move on to the next one. Number 14. The Black Sarcophagus. Back to Egypt now, and we're taking a look at what is known as the Black Sarcophagus. Back in 2018, a huge black sarcophagus dating back to the 4th century BC was discovered in Alexandria, Egypt. Scientists were pretty excited as this meant there was a possibility they had discovered the tomb of Alexander the Great himself in the city he built. But ancient curses were believed to have been put on his tomb, so people worried that opening it could lead to some terrible global catastrophe like a pandemic or something. But of course, that's just superstition and nothing like that would happen in a million years. Anyway, inside were the bodies of three Egyptian soldiers floating in a weird pool of sewage, and now this has become a meme, so after 2,500 years locked in a granite box of sewage, they have become memes. Will their after-death humiliation never end? No one knows who these men were, why they were buried in this unusual sarcophagus, and why it was filled with sewage. If you want to take a look, it's now at the Alexandria National Museum, on display. Number 13. Mummified Moas. Back in the day, people were crazy about mummifying things. It was kind of like the Nintendo Switch of 3,000 years ago, and when there weren't enough dead people to go around, people started mummifying pretty much anything they could get their hands on, including this case of a bunch of giant birds that are basically dinosaurs. Discovered in 1986 in a dark cave on Mount Owen, New Zealand, the giant claw seemed to be from some terrifying prehistoric monster. Although it was not Godzilla, it turned out to be the mummified remains of an upland moa. This 3,300-year-old bird is the largest bird that has ever lived, and stood over 10 feet tall. There were only 10 species of moa roaming the earth, but all are now extinct. Which is probably a relief. At least you would think so, but scientists have got a hold of a good chunk of DNA from this claw, and now think it's possible to clone a moa using a chicken embryo. So New Zealanders better watch out for these things. They might be making a comeback. Number 12. Mummified Child. And we're on to more mummification. Just can't get enough of these mummies, can ya? Well, this time, instead of waiting around for someone to die or going after a giant dino bird, these people went right ahead and straight up killed a kid as a sacrifice and then mummified it. Nice. Around 500 years ago, the Inca had a sacrificial ritual called capacocha. Three children were stuffed with the finest food, beer, and coca, which is the active ingredient in cocaine, so they would go along with the plan. Aged around 12 to 13, they were then taken all the way up to a shrine on the top of Lulayaco volcano, which is now in Argentina. Dressed with elaborate braids and headdresses, the children were then frozen to death, and that is where they remained until their discovery in 1999. The idea was to appease the gods and protect the Incan Empire, but it doesn't seem to have worked out too well, as the mighty empire, once one of the strongest and most powerful in the world, was conquered by the Spanish Empire in 1572 and would never return. Number 11. Cannibal Attack. The mysterious world of human prehistory is truly fascinating. Our knowledge of this time is pretty limited, but we do know that there were other humanoids out there competing and collaborating with us, and some of their behaviors were pretty insane. In Europe and Western Asia, we shared our space with the Neanderthals, and we have long been characterized as cavemen, but it seems they were more complex than first thought. However, they were also capable of serious brutality, and one find from 49,000 years ago provided more evidence that Neanderthals were into cannibalism. A whole family was violently murdered, and then their brains, organs, bone marrow, and everything else removed for food by other Neanderthals. There's plenty of other evidence that Neanderthals would occasionally cannibalize each other, which might explain why they aren't still around today. Humans with paler skin, red or blonde hair, and blue eyes have the highest amounts of Neanderthal DNA in their code. So if a redhead ever looks at you kinda hungrily, better watch out. Number 10. Alien Skulls. Mexico is just full of creepy and weird stuff, which is why I love it. And back in 1999, residents of a Mexican village called Onavas proclaimed to have finally discovered proof of alien life when they uncovered remains in an ancient pre-Hispanic cemetery. Workers digging an irrigation canal stumbled upon the burial site and were terrified by the strange elongated skulls they found there. Furthermore, the teeth were sharp or in strange shapes.
Scientists knew they had something applause-worthy.
But it turned out not to be aliens after all, but the skulls of human children who had their heads ritually deformed. They date from around 1,000 years ago and were an important archaeological find, as it was not until that time believed that skull deformation was practiced as far north as Sonora, where the village is located. There were 25 bodies found there, and the technique to form the strange skulls was to file the teeth and then clamp wooden boards to the head while the child was young and the skull still relatively soft. As it grew, it would grow into these strange shapes, which, to be honest, is even creepier than an alien burial ground. Number 9. The Curse of King Tut. The most famous Egyptian ruler in the world is King Tutankhamun. Even though the boy king was not a major pharaoh in terms of historical importance, the discovery of his tomb by British explorer Howard Carter was one of the most thrilling and important news stories of the 1920s. Carter and his companion George Herbert opened the tomb in 1923. Many older religions used curses and were more closely engaged with the darker side of the human soul than more modern religions like Islam and Christianity, and so those who warned against meddling with the ancients were not surprised when Carter's team began dying in strange ways. The new Italian leader Benito Mussolini, an extremely superstitious man, had Italy's looted Egyptian treasures sent back because he was so afraid of the curse, which became an international news frenzy. Herbert died from an infected mosquito bite on his face, which was found to be identical to a wound on the face of King Tut himself. Number 8. Mass Grave. Mass graves, sadly, are not an uncommon discovery in the field of archaeology. It seems humans have always enjoyed killing a bunch of people, then throwing them in a hole and burying them all together with no ceremony. But one mass grave from the time of the ancient Greeks seemed even more ominous than the average mass grave. No one really knows who they were, but the bodies of 80 men were discovered, with their arms and legs shackled and their jaws agape, suggesting a pretty nasty death and possibly having been buried alive. Dating back to the 7th century BC, some people have speculated that they may have been the followers of an Athenian noble known as Cylon. Cylon tried to overthrow the rulers of Athens in 623 BC, but failed. He managed to escape, but it is recorded that many of his followers were executed, and that could be these poor men here, all of whom were young and in good health when they died. Number 7. Vampire burials. Vampires, as we know, mainly come from Eastern Europe, Transylvania, of course, being home to the most famous of them all, but it's not only in Transylvania. Belief in vampires was long widespread through Eastern Europe in particular, and a lot of evidence of anti-vampiric activity has been unearthed in Bulgaria. During the Middle Ages, the Balkan country saw a huge growth in vampire superstition. The people began to take measures to protect themselves from vampires. It was believed that vampires rose from the graves of the dead, especially if the person died an unusual death, such as by suicide. So the living would remove the legs of suicides and then drive an iron rod through the heart to immobilize the vampire should it try to escape. Sometimes these were just ordinary people, but even rulers who were infamous for their cruel and tyrannical behavior were buried this way. Back in the 13th century, people weren't taking any chances. One such grave was discovered in 2014 in the region of Perpericon, and shows a man with an iron rod nailed in his heart. Hundreds more have been discovered, and the true number could be enormous. Number 6. Nazca Lines. People didn't think too much of the Nazca Lines of Peru for a long time. Until, that is, we developed the ability to see them from the air once the airplane had been invented. Then, suddenly, the true nature of the lines was revealed. Spotted by commercial aircraft back in the 20s and 30s, the mystery surrounding the Nazca Lines has fascinated archaeologists ever since.
Only wearing these huge padded sandals can you actually walk on the area where the Nazca Lines lie.
There are depictions of animals, humans, and geometric patterns, as well as mythological entities. They were made more than 2,000 years ago by the Nazca people, who ruled the region before the Inca. But who were they trying to communicate with? And what were they trying to tell them? Are humans really the first creatures to fly machines in our skies, or did ancient aliens come down to observe the Nazca before deciding to disappear again? Or maybe they're still here, and just better hidden. Sadly, we can't ask the Nazca themselves, as their culture has long since disappeared, probably destroyed by the effects of climate change during that period, and then conquered by rivals, such as the Wahi, but their amazing lines are still with us, in all their mystery. Number 5. The Pyramids. The Great Pyramid of Giza might be the single most famous building in all of the world. It is the oldest and largest of the three Great Pyramids at Giza, and was as amazing and fascinating to the Romans as it is to us. In fact, 2020 is closer in time to Julius Caesar than the time the Great Pyramid was built, so they are pretty old. Built for the pharaoh Khufu in around 2500 BC, it remained the tallest man-made structure on Earth for 3,600 years. It is pretty much every archaeologist's dream to study it. But you might be thinking that with all the studies that have gone on there, there's probably not much more to learn, but you'd be wrong. And the Great Pyramid is filled with unsolved mysteries, with new passages and tunnels being discovered even today. The outer casing is now gone, all of it removed by Muslim rulers of Egypt for building mosques in their new capital of Cairo, with the last pieces plundered in the 19th century. The ancient Greeks were the first Egyptologists, and they believed that the pyramids were built by slaves. But modern discoveries now show that they were likely built by paid laborers, which is better labor regulations than some of the stadiums being built for the new World Cup. Number 4. Shroud of Turin. The Shroud of Turin is a shroud which is believed to show the face of Jesus Christ on an old piece of cloth. It is kept in a church in Turin, which is more gift shop than church, but hey, Jesus needs to make a buck or two. The Catholic Church officially recognized the shroud as a holy artifact back in 1353, but it had been rumored to be in existence since around AD 30. Allegedly, it was found in Judea, then it made its way to the town of Edessa in modern Turkey, then on to Constantinople. In 1204, crusaders sacked Constantinople and brought the shroud back to Christendom, putting it in a church in Athens. Then somehow it ended up in France and finally Turin. Unfortunately, modern radiocarbon dating shows that the shroud didn't make such a crazy voyage and was in fact created sometime in the Middle Ages. Defenders of the shroud, like the Tourist Board of Turin, I guess, said that they carbon dated the wrong part of the shroud and the Jesus-y part was really old. But anyone who is a fan of 1960s psychedelic music will be easily able to solve the mystery and tell you it is pretty obviously a picture, not of Jesus Christ, but of Frank Zappa. Don't eat yellow snow, kids. Number 3. The Copper Scroll. Back in 1952, archaeologists were busy uncovering ancient Jewish religious manuscripts that were found in the Qumran caves of the Judean desert. The first discoveries of what became known as the Dead Sea Scrolls were in 1946, but it is the Copper Scroll, found in 1952, that is the most mysterious.
So this is a particular style of the scribes who copy all this.
There are 981 scrolls in total, most of which are copies of Hebrew scriptures, non-canonical texts from the Second Temple period, and other documents which shed light on the culture of the Jewish sect which created them. But the Copper Scroll is different, being the only one written on copper rather than parchment. Also, this scroll is more of a treasure map than anything to do with scripture. It lists places where gold or silver have been hidden, and is written not in standard literary Hebrew like all the others, but in a language more similar to Mishnah. What the treasure is and where it came from is unknown, but it could be the treasure of the Second Temple, destroyed by the Romans, or even the First Temple, destroyed by Nebuchadnezzar, the Babylonian. Either way, it is considered likely that the Romans would have found and then taken the treasure, so any treasure hunters might be disappointed, but if you want to try, the scroll is now on display. Number 2. The Underground Labyrinth of Death. At Chavin de Hontar, Peru, a 3,000-year-old mystery has finally been brought to light by robots. Underground passageways, which have become known as the Labyrinth of Death, were discovered when archaeologists sent out remote-controlled all-terrain vehicles into the tunnels, equipped with lights and cameras, and maybe some kind of protective talisman and a revolver to deal with any zombies. The Chavin were a major culture in pre-Inca South America, and they built this elaborate network of tunnels up in the Andes Mountains. When the robots went in, they found evidence of human sacrifice taking place in the tunnels. Excavation first began in the 1980s, and researchers were surprised to discover that it had been continuously inhabited until the 1940s, when the last secretive inhabitants left for some reason. Many of those buried there were also the same people who built the tunnels, but they were often buried face down and covered with rocks, something considered to be a dishonorable burial. Although why this happened is still unknown, artifacts from the site are now on display in museums in Lima, the capital of Peru. Number 1. The World's Oldest Cheese. We're going to end on something which is not about dead bodies and child sacrifice, just for a change, because, you know, the past wasn't all vampires and murder. It was also cheese. Archaeologists in Saqqara, Egypt, discovered a cheese which was buried in the tomb of an official who served the pharaoh 3,300 years ago, making it the oldest cheese ever discovered. While you might be imagining what a great pairing this cheese would make with a glass of that granite sarcophagus juice, the bad news is that it is considered to be inedible. Even cheese can go bad after more than 3 millennia just lying around in a dead guy's tomb. It is made from a mixture of cow milk and either goat or sheep milk, and many people believe that this cheese is cursed. Although the curse would have to work quickly to kill you faster than all the bacteria that is in it, should you eat some of it. But that's not all. Even before it passed its best before date, this cheese contained one of the common and dangerous bacteria that still makes unpasteurized cheese dangerous today, causing the sickness known as brucellosis, which isn't fatal but is extremely unpleasant and can damage the heart. this cheese would have been very acidic in flavor, similar to a spreadable chèvre in texture, and apparently a favorite of high-ranking officials in the ancient city of Memphis, not the one in Tennessee. Which of these stories creeped you out the most? Would you prefer a glass of sarcophagus juice or a bite of ancient cheese? Let us know in the comments below. Also, check out our other cool stuff showing up on screen right now. See you next time!